All right, so we'll just settle down and settle into an hour to turn away from the world. So, hopefully you're in a nice quiet room with a nice bit of sun coming in through the window. With the door closed and an hour to yourself. An hour where you have no responsibilities. An hour where you don't have to get anything done. You can leave all that aside. You're safe. And you're alive. So allowing yourself to draw inward. Away from the mind that is busy, that has so many duties. And drawing it inward, opening up to yourself. Noticing what you hear inside, what you hear inside your body and mind. And allowing yourself to feel those feelings. Giving yourself permission to hear yourself. So bring in your mind to the present moment. Noticing what thoughts feel like. We're so busy thinking all the time, but sometimes it's easier rather than notice the thought, but notice the feelings that are associated with those thoughts. Feelings in the body. Feelings of pushing, pulling, coldness, heat, tension, relaxation. Not resisting anything, but giving your permission to feel, giving yourself permission. So if your mind wanders away to thoughts and all its usual activities, giving it space, not drawing it back like a awful boss, but giving it space, allowing it to untangle. being friends with yourself means that it is easier to be friends with others. Friend with our own minds, our minds that do all kinds of crazy things. Our mind that we think is ours, me, I'm in charge, but it rarely is. So we learn to accept and just let ourselves be. Giving ourselves a lot of space. Because we don't have to do anything for the next hour. Allowing yourself to disengage. in your mind. Running too far away. Giving it space, allowing it just to be itself. Being the mother that patiently watches its child and all its antics. Just gently bringing it back. Without judgment. Again, noticing what your mind is up to. Letting it relax, but also knowing what is going on. Withdrawing from the world. But not creating another world of fantasy. Just getting to know, just being with what is. Learning to take our foot off the pedal. When we take our feet off the pedal, the car goes here and there. but in this hour, we are safe. So let it do its thing. Bringing your mind if it has wandered away. Hopefully to a sense of a friendly place that you're a friendly person for your mind to come back to. A friend that has no expectation. A friend that doesn't particularly judge. So for the last 10-15 minutes of the meditation, perhaps we can bring to mind all the things that we have done this week. All the things that we should appreciate, sir, we appreciate ourselves for. All our hard work, all the times we've been there for someone else, all the times that we have let go. I'm sure there have been many such moments this week. So taking a bit of time to appreciate ourselves. Appreciate the time we didn't get angry. When we held back from saying a hurtful word. That we might have helped a colleague. Or a child. Or a friend. I took time to send an email that was carefully worded. Cooked a meal for someone else. And then maybe we spend the last few minutes appreciating what others have done for us or have done for each other, someone else. People in our lives who we take for granted. All of us just doing what we think is best. We come to the towards the end of the meditation. Of appreciating ourselves and appreciating what others do as well. Just our family, but also all the people who work in the shops, work in the hospitals, work behind computers, work in the government. Appreciating all the good that is being done. So bringing your mind back to this room, back to your body. Back to the space that we're in. And sharing the merit of all our lives, really. Sharing the merit of our practice. Wishing that somehow all beings are touched. All beings feel this space, this acceptance. May all beings be at ease. May all beings be at peace. And when you're ready, you can slowly open your eyes. If anybody would like to say anything in the chat, they're most welcome. But it's all right to sit quietly as well. Kim says thank you. Thank you, Kim. So we've just got to. So rejoicing in the calm meditation. Yeah, sure. Art has a question, but I realize we went a little bit longer than we usually do. Perhaps Manori can finish up and Art, maybe afterwards you don't hang up and then you can ask your question because probably, yeah. Okay.
Thank you again, Venerable, for this wonderful meditation program. And it was a bit different today and you know, being with our feelings, and I hope all of us, like, you know, felt like that. And as you know, all these programs are given by Anukampa Bhikkhuni Project on donation basis, and we are very grateful for all your donations. I'm going to put the normal donate. Link, so you can go to the anukampaproject.org slash donate. And also there are events page, and you can see the new events coming with Ajahn Ramali and Ajahn Brahm in June. And this coming week is a very important week for us, that the Vihari is going into a big new monastery, and there'll be new ways of administering it, and it's a bigger place to manage as well. So all your donations are quite welcome, big or small it is. It all matters when it adds up. If you want to get more involved, please contact team@anukampaproject.org. So if you want to be volunteering, if you want to get into a group, there are so many different ways. Or you might want to drop a dana, that is some online food, cooked food or online supermarket delivery. That is available as well. So there are so many different ways available to involve in the project. Thank you very much again.
Thank you, everyone. And see you next Saturday. Oh, no, see you on Wednesday, those who come on Wednesdays. And if you want to stay back and listen to Art's question, you're welcome to as well. But yes, have a lovely weekend. Take care.